Yeah, and
Sorry, because we have forgotten to register when it falls down.
you know,
I'm sorry.
Okay.
No, I'm registering again because when it fell down.
Okay. I choose my PDF file. Okay. It's the one I want to configure. Okay, I add, and then my file. This is file two. Okay. Mm-hmm. One other important, but of less priority. Okay, it is file image. Okay, it gives information to the user to which type of file is opening,
downloading.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, yes.
We have had I think in the back end, image of a zip and PDF at least, or maybe also JPG, something like that.
Here
yeah.
it is.
Yeah.
Every project has at disposal this folder, docs and tools file type, in which are an image of doc, Microsoft Word, a PDF file, a PDF image, and a zip. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. You can add also the others.
Possiamo fornirgliela noi se ce la chiedono.
Yeah.
In this case, it's a PDF. So I check PDF. You know, it's a graphic. It's an image. It's an accessory.
Yes.
It's not relevant, but it's useful for the user. Okay. I can publish and save this.
Wait a second.
Yes.
Show them now, just please. You're so kind. You have added the hypothetical first document. Now, if they want to add another one, just let them see the plus button, which they have to press. That will open the new space. This is the one.
Here it is.
Now presses, it's under this widget. If Enrica presses, you won't see anything happen. But if you scroll down, you see that the new space has opened. Okay? The new space is open, and you can do this N times you want to repeat the new space for the new document, new content. Also, if you want to put a document you've forgotten, I want to have a document that it's 2.1.1 and that I have uploaded 2.1.2.3, and I want to upload the document 2.1.2, you can, after the 2.1.1, you can add plus, and the space will open in between so that everything is nicely in order by the number of your deliverables.
Okay, here it is. If I want a new space here between the file two and the file three, okay, I put myself in the file two, okay, I press plus, and between file two and file three, Lively put me a new space. Okay. Here it is. Pay attention where you click plus. Put yourself in the right place, okay, between the previous and the next file. Click plus. I can click another one. So I have here a space, and here a new space, and then my file three. Okay. I for error check this one. I can erase. I can in this way. Okay.
That's great.
Okay.
I think this is quite quite easy and quite understandable. I take over just a question from Anna from chat. If we have any, Enrica, any heavy documents, I don't know what does she intend to be heavy. Do we have any limitation for the backup and upload? They need to resize a little bit them? Okay.
I think yes. Okay. I non sono sicura. I think
there is some limitation.
Sì,
so it's
yes.
If Anna, if
ma gliela faccio sapere magari.
Yeah. We will let you know to Anna this if there is some limitation for the documents dimension.
If it's think very... 25 megabyte.
Okay.
I think.
Okay.
Ho questo ricordo.
Yeah, I think it would be good that if you can resize the document to be a little less heavy to be able to upload it in the back end. I think this is the best way, Anna. And then we can check case by case. It depends on what is it, but possibly all the final deliverables should be on the back end and then pulled on the front end of the web page.
Yes.
Okay. So I think if this is I think that we have cleared this this section.
Non la trovo, ma te la eccolo qua. Mm-hmm. Attenzione, upload documents no larger than 100 megabyte.
100 is quite a lot.
Quite a lot. Please don't.
I don't know what Anna has, but.
please.
Okay, let's. I would suggest, thanks a lot. I think that this is quite clear. We will come back to the questions also of Vladimir, of course. We haven't forgotten on these. And I would suggest now to move further on, to go on, to show you the other contents, and that to enable also Enrica to show you how to do with the multimedia on
gallery.
Okay. So
ti do la palla.
Okay. Just okay. Briefly, and then I will give it back to you. Allora. So, thank you for your patience. Okay, so we are here now. I hope you can see it again. We have seen what about the library section and the projects that have lost it. Please restore it according to the indications from the video tutorial. If you have any problems, let me know, I can support you, but you have to have it because you need to update it with the documents as soon as possible, as soon as these are in final version. Uploading the final multimedia, photos and the videos. So we have, you have seen that you have multimedia in homepage and that you have a multimedia in menu bar. Okay, so initially we thought that multimedia in homepage, which is the line down under, would be useful for the most representative images of your project that are able to storytell your core business, now your activities that have taken place on ground and the main results, like to show even something that sometimes maybe usual for you, for some others that can be very interesting from the pilot projects that are taking place, building up or photos before and after and so on and so forth. And this space is dedicated for this kind of high quality pictures that can give immediately an overview about your project and main project activities. So please not images from the events of the audience, but some more conceptual or a very high level, high quality images. Optimization of photo, please take care that to resize them in this pixel indicated for all the galleries. Otherwise, they won't be visualized as they should be. You will upload them on the website backend. There is already the dedicated folder we have created for you. So it's very easy. Multimedia in the menu bar, it's supposed to be for the single images of your events, of your project events or thematic events or high level events that have taken place, or also pilot actions that have taken place on the territories. When you prepare in subfolders and rename them as indicated, then when you go to that section, the photos will drop down from the menu according to all every single event that can be shown like this. So the photos from events should be uploaded over there in the multimedia in the, that is shown in the menu bar. And also some most representative photos of these events can be included in the follow-up report of the event that you will upload as a document in the library. Then we have also the possibility, as you know, to create a frame in the home page for the most representative and professional edited videos that you have prepared, like AdsVim has a very nice video in animated graphics. I know other projects that have created as a final deliverable, like KQ Plus, nice videos for showing the forgotten recipes from the area, reinterpreted by the famous chefs. So these that are the final deliverables of videos that are final deliver meant to be the final deliverables of the project, or are very nice and quality videos, you can drag them and show them in the homepage, but not uploading them on the backend, just linking them from YouTube according to our user manual. So I will stop here and Enrica will show you also this part. And then we have just a couple of other slides to clarify, and then we can pass it through to the questions. Okay.
Okay. It's very, very simple, the issue about the multimedia galleries, because we have to do only one step, okay? Only the step that regards the documents and media area. And the images will be automatically displayed in this section, okay? We have not to, we have any other step to do. Important is the previous activity on your local desktop to resize and prepare the image in to be displayed in this proportion and this dimension, 102,000 to 8,000, okay, and be very aware, pay attention to the dimension, to the weight of the file, the image file. Web and website are not our backup for our galleries, our photos. You have to do in any way a selection and an editing, post-editing of the photos before the uploading them on the website. It's very, very important also for the performance of your website. if every image has a dimension of 4, 5, 6 megabyte, your website will be very, very, very lazy, very lazy. Okay, so we have to basically go to documents and media. Okay, we find two folder, multimedia galleries, that is the one which is in the navigation bar, and multimedia gallery home, that is the gallery dedicated to the home page. Okay, here we will have some selection, some image. Pay attention, this KQ Plus made some folder, but it's not necessary. You can put directly here in this multimedia gallery home folder directly the 10, 15, maximum 20 image selected image. Okay, I will show you this issue about in the program website. Dov'è quello della home? Mi sono perso.
Dovresti averla, sei nella cosa nostra o nella cosa sì. del progetto? Forse è più semplice. Del progetto? Vado. Sei? No, forse è più semplice se entri nel progetto perché sì. c'è meno contenuto.
Sì, sì, mm-hmm. sì, hai ragione. Okay. Sorry. Ok. I repeat, you have to enter documents in media and you will find multimedia gallery home. It's not necessary to organize it in folder, okay? Put here the 15, maximum 20 selected images directly in this folder. The folder is multimedia gallery home, okay? It's not necessary to organize it in folder.
Very important. Because it doesn't cluster in the home page. It doesn't cluster in the other gallery.
Yes. So. Thank you. This is the point. Okay. So I put it by the drag and drop by my desktop or make an upload of multiple documents, it's the same, okay? You make drag and drop here, 15, 20 selected image prepared for web publication. Which means dimensions and weight in appropriate configuration. So you can make images in about 2,000 kilobyte maximum, to 200, 250 maximum, okay? It's very, very important. Okay, and voglio farglielo vedere, aspetta.
Sì.
Okay, and you have this result. Let's go to see in the okay. This is the result. Okay, and these are the
it's a demo.
Yes,
that you have to eliminate before, right? Mm-hmm. And also from the recycle bin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. And these are the results. Here I have the photo and here I have the menu to scroll images, okay? The different is the multimedia gallery on the website and the navigation bar, okay? This one, because it's clustered, okay? So, qua,
No, they haven't entered yet the photos. Unfortunately, we have, there is some issue, but we can fix them for you.
Guardiamo quello di Kiku Plus.
Kiku Plus scroll. Has a nice or other standard plus projects, have a nice scroll down. Also, ML Repair has beautiful images from the pilot actions on territories when we were able to make.
Okay, this one has a list. Okay, a folder. These are folder. Okay, that I can choose. Okay, and multimedia. Let me see the images inside this folder. Let's go to the backend. We go to the documents and media. Okay, ve lo faccio vedere.
Yeah, another scheda, okay. Mm-hmm. And you will see that they have created the folders for each of these.
Yes. Eccolo qua.
No, this is of Italy, Croatia.
Sorry, yes. Here it is. Okay. This is Kiku Plus Documents and Media Area. È lentissimo perché è mezzogiorno. yes. Multimedia Galleries. Here there are. Every folder has its own images. Okay. And in the front end, here is the way in which will be displayed. These are the folder, okay. 5.2, 5.1, and title of the folder, and this is the results in the front end. Okay. It's not necessary to make any other step. You can put here a new folder and put in the folder the new images by drag and drop, and in the front end appears a new voice of this list, a new multimedia gallery. No other step are needed in this way.
Exactly.
Very, very simple. Pay attention, a warning. If you want the late one because you by mistake put in the wrong way or the wrong images, okay, you select and put in the recycle bin, okay. For example, this you put in the recycle bin, but you have to pay attention to go to recycle bin after this operation, you to the recycle bin and erase and eliminate by the recycle bin, okay, to be sure that
it's clear
exactly
that demo. So we have entered this information also in the user manual, so
yes,
you create
yes.
the folders, you eliminate the demo, then you go to the recycle bin and you just clear it out.
Well,
and
everything
should be okay. Yeah,
you have
remove
to remove
the demo.
Okay. And go and so on. Everyone, every step is shown about.
Yeah.
Okay. This is the important notice of deleting some item. Remember to remove there also from recycle bin. And it's shown.
Yeah. The recycle bin is on the left side, the left bar of that backend menu. I think that Rika has shown you on.
Yes.
It's
here
over
it
there. Uh-huh. So you
here
just. Yeah. So this means I am just reconnecting to another question that I have received through the G form. Somebody asked, do they have this possibility to modify, to eliminate any contents, of course, you have the possibility to eliminate the news. Also, you have that recycle bin, and eliminated contents will go to the recycle bin. And then if you want to clear it out and empty, you just do like Ulrika shown to you. Okay, so
You can eliminate, you can delete a web content or an item of documents and media. You can delete every single item you create by mistake. And then you you go to recycle bin and clear. Or, non so come si fa a recuperare.
Recover to
restore. Recover, or restore, mm-hmm. Restore. Sorry.
Restore the erased, not a problem. Mm-hmm. You can recover, restore the erased things that are in the recycle bin. Okay, so I think that this part is quite clear. If there are any questions, of course, can be entered in the chat. Now we can see adding the frame for the video connection from the YouTube, and that will be the last issue of our presentation. And we'll see, as I said.
Okay. I show you, for example, QQ Plus that have very very. Good work with the video link, item. This feature has been added in time, so you have to add it following the steps shown in the manual that are very, very clear, because you have first step add your widget, because this feature has been added in a second time. So you don't have neither the widget in on page. So the first step is going to this new is a unique case in which you have to manage by this menu, okay?
Yeah, on the right. Otherwise, it's always the center or the left. This is the only case when you work with the right sidebar to add the frame that will allow you then to enter the content for the video.
Now we call it a widget, okay? The video link widget, okay? First of all, you have to follow this step, add search in widget, search for asset publisher, okay? You will find this one, and I will show you, okay?
Yeah, if they start here, writing down AS, then it will appear.
Here it is. Non so se lo vogliamo aggiungere su Marles piuttosto che.
Yeah, we can try to add it to Marles there in parallel. Don't be afraid, anything can be restored. When you drag and drop, now we'll see it will appear a little bit untidy. Seems to be untidy, mm-hmm. But then with your actions, you will go to config. Yeah, no fear. Well, with your actions, you will go to configure it. And so let's see for the Marles if they would like to put videos between the library and multimedia.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I go to this menu, I search asset publisher. Okay.
Here it is.
I put it here between library and multimedia. Pay attention, this operation is
delicate, drag and drop. Yeah. Just you see.
Opa. Okay.
It goes. Yeah. So it appears. You see.
Don't fear. Don't be afraid. Okay.
Configure it.
Okay. Let's go to configure our widget, okay? First of all, okay? First, configuration, okay? Every step is shown in the manual. Click here and then asset selection. We go to select the web content in this asset type, but which content article? Video link, okay? Here it is. So asset type, web content article, video link.
Yeah, okay. It's like from the user manual, just step by step.
Yes,
a couple
yes.
of fields okay. that need to be configured.
Yes.
Okay, so these are web content are. Article and video link. And then display setting, right?
Display setting. Okay.
Shows,
we have a video link. Okay. We can display a number of items, perhaps 20 is very, very,
yeah.
very, very large number. You can put it 5, 6, 10, 100, okay, at your disposal, at your choosing.
Yeah, just not to be too long on the page, but if you have 20 quality videos, do show them.
Okay.
yeah. if you have 20 quality videos, why not?
okay, why not? Why not?
Yeah.
And then you have complete the configuration about the asset publisher. Okay.
Maybe subscription? Maybe subscription?
Say subscription level. Uh-huh.
Okay.
Enable every subscription. Okay. Very important. Save. And save. It's done. Okay.
If you scroll.
Let's go. And one more configuration
Here it is.
Okay.
Now we have to do the look and feel.
Configuration. Okay.
Second one.
Where it is? Non mi ricordo solo no title.
Yeah, no title. I think just no title.
Sorry about
that. Or video, I'm not quite sure, but yeah.
Sorry, yeah.
Uh-huh. Or nested, I don't know.
No,
it's down under, I think. No.
Sorry.
I can help. Let me check. I will see in parallel prima, while you are prima, working.
La prima. Eccolo qua, yeah. Eccolo qua.
Okay, uh-huh.
Sorry. Mm-hmm. Advanced style, okay. Mm-hmm. News, minus event, minus nested, okay. And then in general, use custom title. And here you can type your title, video, most beautiful video. You can choose whichever title you like, okay? And in advanced style, these two tab, ignore this.
Yeah.
This one.
So general and advanced setting, styling, mm-hmm. yeah.
Mm-hmm. News event nested.
Still?
You have this in the manual. You can forget. If you forget, you get here and type, okay. And then
save.
In this way, we put a
frame.
Frame. With is un
eccolo qua here it is
okay
here it is
okay
now we add
now
a video
we can add a video you
Link.
Have to first of all upload your video on YouTube and get the right link okay but you can add a new video in this way. You can put here a title for you and a title for the user. You can see it's mandatory, okay? So I can video of today.
If you need an iframe, I can pass you through chat if you can take it over, if it's not complicated, okay. Or if you have somewhere else.
If you want, you can put a subtitle or a description in the manual. You can see which are the here are. Okay. Mm-hmm. The title and the description. And obviously, the video link. Okay.
The iframe. You take over from your YouTube the iframe. We can show you, it's easy. It's not the link that you give to the user to go directly, but it's that incorporate, okay? And it gives you this iframe that you copy and paste, okay?
Not so, the link, yeah, not this not link, the link, but this one which you can get from here, from this button. This is the link, okay? And paste in this field, YouTube
exactly.
Link.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's like this. It has always iframe. This is kind of iframe.
The correct name, the technical name is iframe.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
You can see it here, iframe. Okay. You copy this, simply copy and paste in this field.
Space, yeah.
And then you can publish, and this is the result in your page. This is the result. If you want to add another video, click again on the plus button, okay, and restart the procedure. Restart from here. Click plus. New video link, and the widget display your new video.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So they don't need to recreate again the frame because they already have
absolutely.
They have to just put the content of the video that they want to be displayed. Linked from YouTube, and then it will appear as it does. For example, we took QQ Plus down under each another.
Yes.
Left, right,
step,
left, right.
Step one. Okay. Go to see this.
Like this.
Okay. Okay. Step one. Step two. Once for all. Okay. Because you have to configure the frame and the look and feel. Then you can put video link, add a new video by this instruction many time, illimited time.
Yes, illimited. I think that it will display how many times they have given in the frame.
Yes.
If you give 3, then it will give you the possibility to put 3. Otherwise, you have to revise a little bit the frame. You just re-enter on the frame.
Yes. So
you
the
say, no, I don't want it anymore. 3, I would like 10. Then you re-enter
Let's
the configuration.
See.
You put more.
QQ Plus display setting, 20. You can put 200. You can put 2000. Okay. As you want. Okay.
Esatto.
It seems difficult, but it's very, very easy if you follow step by step this instruction, because and give you satisfaction, I think. Okay, this is the title and this is the description. You can put it or not, or only a title. Title and video, title, description, and video. A widget automatically display once on the left, once on the right. Okay, in this way, automatically.
Okay, I think this is really quite clear. If something is not clear, please write it down in a chat. And Enrica, is there anything you would like to add, or we can continue briefly to pass?
Continue.
So I take over this, I think that I will. I think that I will also reply this to some questions that I have noticed arrived in chat and that Lovro is so kindly collecting. So we have seen the videos. Let's see what should not be uploaded. So Vladimir asked, among the other things, about what not should be uploaded, or if there is any doubt about this. As I wrote in the guidelines for the publishing of deliverables, you upload on the website all the deliverables is indicated in the guidelines, but you don't upload the work package one material, because the work package one is the management work package and contains official documents of the project, internal guidelines for or the deadlines and so on. So it's not a communication issue, and this is something that you don't have to upload. I've seen that some projects have uploaded a partnership agreement, subsidy contract. Please download this. Nobody cares about that. This is something internal. This is your internal document. Of course, when your first level controller comes to your premises or checks out the expenditures and so on, we'll ask you for the first thing to see the subsidy contract and the partnership agreement, but it's not something that the program and the general public is interested at. Also, I remind the event attendance sheets. Please. According to the GDPR, we don't publish anymore, not even send you. If you remember when we have had the last events in presence offline, we haven't published the attendance sheet online scanned as it was the case before 2018. But we have prepared for you the specific certifications of the attendance that the DMA director signed during the event. This is the same thing. Please don't publish the attendance sheets of your events, both if these were online or offline. You will categorize give evidence to your audience in your follow-up report, which I have mentioned before and which you have been introduced with during the lead partner seminars, both for the standard and both for the strategic. You will write down the main issues of the day, the main highlights of the speeches, and also mention the composition of your audience. So it means we have had 10 representatives of regional public bodies, 3 of NGOs, and so forth, and so on and so forth. And in total, they were present 100 persons from and invitees. So please take care about this. No publishing of attendance sheets. Also, some documents that may be the part of work package two, such as communication strategy. I would advise not to publish this document because, according to my experience at least, contain the names and indications of your stakeholders. So it's a document that is relevant for your for orienting your strategy and for your partnership. But you can of course, and you have in certain cases shared it with me, or you have always uploaded it on CU, but don't publish this document, okay? Another confidential documents, signed agreements, memorandums of understandings. This is not relevant to be published, okay? The other things that come to my mind that should not be uploaded, for example, I have mentioned in the guidelines, because there was a case with the Standard Plus projects. Perhaps if there is any document like we arrive sometimes to the final deliverables by producing documents and analysis on local level and maybe in local language. If these analyses are functional to the production of the final deliverable of some specific action, that it's not so important to have it on online. If it was for example a survey or analysis or something that was useful and whose contents were included in that final document that contains all the analysis and surveys gained from the stakeholders in the area, then the final deliverable of, I don't know, phase of the activity 5.2 should be published. I hope this is clear for you. It's a logic. So, and to summarize and to repeat, there are still some projects that haven't uploaded all the logos and all the descriptions of the project partners on the G form. Please do so. Somebody asked in the G form, and I'm quite surprised that this is an old activity that we've done at the beginning. But if you haven't, please remind that we have created a G form. I have created a G form for both standard and strategic projects, where I have collected all the logos and all the descriptions of the project partners, in order to be able myself to upload them on each of your websites, because this is a centralized section and it's program reserved, only we can do it. This is always open form, so you can always use it and reuse it for any small change, adjustment, both in a logo or in the description of the partner, or if the contact person changes, don't be afraid. Just use this because it's very important for me, because I have you are 61 plus other projects. It would be very, very difficult to track all the changes that are occurring. So I have this G form, and when you upload any change, just notify me by email that you have some updates to be done on your web page, and I will check out and do this for you, because this is a centralized section and only we can do it. You cannot do it for now. So, but we are always available and have always adjusted your according to your indications. Also remind that Adolfo Cola Giovanni Benvenuto, that the logos need to have, as I have communicated to you several times, a certain form. It should be square and at least 120x120. If I'm not wrong, please, Erika, correct me. Otherwise, it won't be able to display well. Okay, because the logo then will be distorted. Have this in mind before you upload it on the G form. Okay, I think this is the last from my side. As you know, in 2019, at the beginning of August, we have activated the call center, whose email is indicated here, for any functional troubleshooting and lack of features functioning. So summarizing, you have some issues to respect in order to gain some explanation or a resolution of your problem. please have in mind, just functional. If the server doesn't work, if anything falls down, if you don't know how to do it because it's not written in the user manual. Okay, please. So if you have any doubt, contact me, because in some cases I have managed to help you directly. In other cases, when it's not possible, then you should open a ticket and I indicate it to you. To summarize, you can revise and find all the communications for the fulfillment of the standard and strategic project tasks on the website. These are the dates with my communications towards you, towards all the appointed web content managers. And with all in detail indications that are also available on our program website, together with the documents that we have illustrated at the beginning. Okay, my contacts, you know, already them. Everybody's free to contact me. There is also a cell phone, so don't hesitate. Okay. Allora, I would now thank you, Ivana. Okay, so now we can, I hope that everything is clear to you by now. We will check, I will check now the questions that have arrived both via Gform and now that Lovro has taken over from the chat, and we will try to answer to all of these if these not have not been answered yet. If you please give me just a second, I beg your pardon, please 1 minute and I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. Thank you very much for the patience. I needed to open the door. So, okay, if you want, you can turn on your cameras. I would like to see you. Now we are a little bit more free. Okay, so let's go just through the questions. I will start with Lucas that arrived through the Gform. I think that we have he asked about managing contents related to news events and loading the videos, managing the library, and I think that we have answered to these questions by the means of our presentation and practical session. Is that true? Okay.
Yes,
okay.
The answer. Yeah. I'm fully satisfied.
Okay, I'm very pleased. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Luca.
Thanks to you. Really.
Thank you. There was some additional question of yours about managing additional pages. And I reconnect to some other questions that have arrived on this. Yes, there is a possibility to add some other new pages. Okay. And it's, please indicate it to me by the means of email, or you can call me. So we will see what is it about and how much the effort does it take. And we will see what kind of content do you need. And if we possibly can arrange for you some additional pages we will be glad to do that, of course, in coordination with our managing authority and our service provider. Okay. Yes, there is also a comment from Anna, and yes, she said it's not sometimes very intuitive, it takes time to figure out. I hope that we have managed to clear out some issues about these doubtful parts. And okay, tutorials. Zrinka asks about the tutorials. I have already introduced these. These are available on the program YouTube channel. Okay, and CMS, she said, is the most complicated ever encountered, and quite rigid. So while it's quite clear when stating what should be published. Zrinka, yours is more a comment-like, so I hope that we have managed to clear out your doubts. If we haven't, please open your microphone and do intervene.
You did, thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot. Then we have Anna. Anna Sinkovic, yes, she said that also website is not so very friendly, that it takes time to figure out and a lot of effort. Yes, I know, we know, and we are in the same position. Of course, I hope also for Anna that now we cleared out additionally some things that we have already discussed in a couple of private sessions we had also on the standard project before, not only for Mimosa. And what about the pilots? Yes, Anna, we spoke about the pilots, and I have explained to you that, as I said before, it is possible to create new contents and new sections, but what I need from you is to indicate to me which kind of the content you need and which kind of functionalities do you need where, and we will see how can we do this as the same thing that I said for Luca before. So we can treat this by email, not of course now. I invited you, but I have not seen any specific indication from your side. This is why we not proceed. It's not that it's impossible. Everything is possible on web. But please let me know which kind of need you have, and we will try to see what we can do. Nicoletta said that the system doesn't allow her to upload the PDF file. I hope that now it's possible for you, Nicoletta. Have you tried? Can we do anything else to clear your doubts? Because
absolutely, yes. And now I have understand how to upload. No, I tried it with the function attachment, and of course, as you explained, attachment is not relevant, and so now we will try to use the
the
right procedure.
Okay. Yes. The attachment for the events and news is not a functionality, so you have to first put
absolutely
in the folder in the backend whatever you want, then you just pull it out. For the docs and tools, the procedure is the same, but the attachment button does do. So
thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Saspas Dora, she's a new web content manager. Very welcome from the program side. I hope that this session was useful for you to clarify the functionalities and to support your everyday work. Is Dora here? Lazaric? Can't can hear from her. Patricia just said web administrator. I did not understand. If you want to intervene, Patricia. I don't know if she's here with us. Everybody's free to open the mic now. And I will go through the other questions. Nicola asked how to restore the event section in about the project page. It was accidentally erased. I think that we have answered to this question also during the Enrica's presentation.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, Nicola, thank you. Also to the question of Francesca from Inox of publishing the videos, I think that we have answered.
Yes. Yes, okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Francesca. And then I have, okay, the question from Laura, topic of interest is a potential new website features and the user manual updates. Yes, we have seen that perhaps we can add two more clarifications on the user manual with Enrica. These are especially downloading the stay updated list of your stakeholders and the feature that tells you how to re-enter to your content if you haven't tagged well the metadata and the display page. So I think that after this event, we can check it out with Enrica and update these two small parts that are perhaps missing in the explanations. Okay, and for the potential new website features, as I said before, let us know what would you need and we will see come dire come vi possiamo accontentare, what we can do about this, okay. How much development does it take? And of course, because, you know, developing new parts, it depends if it's just adding on or checking out something and it's easy, it's not a problem. If it's a new development, of course, we have to refer to the managing authority, which has a contract and relation with the provider, of course. And Jasna asked us about the statistics of visiting official website. I think that this was indicated to the projects in one of these communications, how to ask the opening for the statistics of visiting of official website. I'm not sure has this been implemented. Jasna? Cannot hear from Jasna. But we will check. Okay.
Another. Yes, I'm here. Sorry.
Okay, sorry. Jasna.
Hi, I'm here.
Ciao. Yes.
Ciao. Hello, everybody.
Okay. Has this issue been solved for you, for your project?
Yes, I have put two questions, and the first one was answered during this seminar. Yes. And the second one is regarding the allowance from your side to collect and to follow entering to our website, because we have asked a call center via email, you mentioned here, and we got the number. They have received our question, but we have never received reply. So until now, we do not have statistics of our website, but we are publishing all news, we are publishing registration forms, everything, but we cannot follow statistics.
Okay, we will check this part with the call center and come immediately to you on this. Okay, Enrica.
Il progetto
è progetto è Innova, scusa, Innova Mare.
Ok,
Mare.
Sì.
Guardo subito. Vediamo. I didn't understand the question about Görgur, but I think that I have that we have already explained how and which deliverables should be uploaded, because he just wrote down hosting deliverables. So I think that this was clarified. Otherwise, I invite Gergo to come back and to write me or call me.
Sorry to interrupt you. May I ask you one more question regarding the logos of our partners? Some of logos are not upload in the best way. So yes. Should we do it, or we should send you the right form of logos and you can do it? I'm not sure.
I said this is centralized the feature and you cannot do anything about this. It's only the program that can do, but you, okay. You just adjust the logos that need to be square and at least 120 per 120 pixel.
Mm-hmm.
And upload it on the G-form.
Okay.
We have okay. That G-form always open. Just let me know when you have uploaded everything that you want to change, adjust, and then I will do this for you. Is it okay, Jasna?
Yes, thank you very much.
Okay.
Hi.
No problem. Uh-huh.
Hi, so, I have the same problem with the logos and with the description, and I tried to do it twice or three times myself, but simply did not change anything. So now I do it again on the G form and then I send the email to you.
Yes, because I have, Daniela, you are presenting which project, excuse me?
Cascade.
Okay. At the beginning of the project, in one of these emails that I have sent to the web content administrators, I have underlined that this is the only centralized section of your website, and you cannot change it again. It's only the program, me or Enrica on behalf of the program, that can adjust. I have uploaded, 700 project logos and descriptions, but I have the G form where I collect everything because I have 82 projects and otherwise it would be a mess. So when every time you need it, I repeat, upload it on the G form, let me know, and I will do this for you. Always available. I do it every month. There is some request from the project partners, so no problem. But please have in mind that if the logos are not in square version, that these cannot be very well displayed. So have in mind this.
Yes, yes.
Let me
other
know.
Question. Can just one project partner, if there's a change in communication person, so be changed, but at the time? So I send you the email or app, because from my experience, when I was uploading in G form, every time ask me every single step from leading partner until the last partner. And I'm on the project where I have 15 partners.
Yes, but it's not compulsory to fill out all the spaces. You
did
can
not
fill
show,
only...
it, it not, no, no. Did not show me differently. Okay.
You can upload only, if you change only one partner, you can upload just this logo and his new contact person and description.
On the other side, today yeah. With us, there was Ivana Cehic, which will be the new administrator for Cascade. So it's good thing that actually she started with this seminar before
yes, okay.
She went inside. Yeah. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's good, and for this purpose, at the beginning of this seminar, I said that I have noticed that some people changed, but I was not informed. So I created the file in Excel that I have shared with all of you. Please, if any change occurred in the web administrator, put it inside name, surname, and email, because we need it for all the communications. And all the tasks that are that web administrators are in charge for.
Is it possible
okay.
To have two web administrators?
Sorry.
Is it possible to have two web administrators for the project?
No, you can have how many persons you want that operationally work on your backend, but one is responsible. And for one, we have created the credentials. We have the possibility to create it for one. So you, if you want to share them among you with more people, you are you are able to do. It's not a problem.
Okay.
Okay. So please let me go through because there are some other questions I have had from Carmela from Šibenik. When publishing news events about the project, we don't have a visible option to delete it. If we put something by mistake, we can only update once we publish it. Can we, as web administrators, add the option to delete it, or that is the permission of the program? No. Carmela, as I said, and as Enrica shown to you before, you can delete what anything you want. There is a button and there is a recycle bin where you can place the content you don't want to use anymore. About the second question, we are planning to publish a database of photos regarding the project. I think that I have already sent an email with you, exchanged an email with you. Our, as Enrica said, your project is not an archive of and a library for the photos. You can publish some photos, but you but if it's 1,000 photos, as you said, it's not the proper tool to do it. What you can do is to plan, as for example, for the other content, as it is the videos. You can upload the videos on YouTube and then link it to your project. The same for the photos. I'm not quite sure about the types of the photos you have. I hope if these are wonderful photos, you can also foresee Flickr or Instagram as well, which Instagram is quite difficult in case of the projects of the territorial cooperations because we don't usually have these amount and this frequent amount of quality photos, but if you do, it's okay. Okay. Setting a video gallery is a section with video clips with the similar smaller video products of the project look the same as the photo gallery. It's a question from Jenny. Jenny, you said you have had some problems with the video gallery. But let us know if the procedure illustrated is helpful, or are there any other issues that you want to ask to me or to Enrica?
No, Thea, I will try later. So if there are some problems again, I will contact you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay, Jenny, thank you. No problem. I'm available and you can call me at any time you want. If I cannot reply immediately, I will call you back. Alessia, creation of news and events, possibility to insert link to social media pages. Yes, I think it's the very, very last thing that we have not shown, but creation of news and events, we have explained. And also in the user manual, there is an explanation on how to enter the links to the social media pages. Maybe Enrica can show it to you again. It's a very simple procedure. From the footer, you can enter directly and add links to your social media pages. As you know,
qual è il progetto?
Progetto è Stream.
Stream.
Sì.
Thank you.
Ok.
Un attimo, che lo troviamo così. E poi si possono anche scoprire.
Perfetto.
Stream scritto così proprio.
Right.
Stream, sì, sì, right. Sì.
Ok. So, in the footer, ok, you have... patient. Okay. Mm-hmm. You have this web content mm-hmm. always with this button. Okay. You can edit. Okay. And you can put every link to your profile. Okay.
Okay.
In particular, YouTube link, Vimeo, Instagram, Flickr,
Twitter. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. That's very clear. Thanks.
Okay. I repeat. You go to the footer.
Footer.
Okay. Where in the in this part where is the follow us?
Follow us.
Appear these three bullet. Okay.
Right.
You click edit web content and you get the field. Please pay attention. You have to fill only the social media information. Okay.
Just if the link.
Put, if you put here your link, the logo will be displayed automatically.
Okay.
We know you. Some of you have asked many times for LinkedIn. We are going to add also LinkedIn to this list. Okay. At the moment, you can't insert link of LinkedIn. Okay.
Okay.
But we add. Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Alessia. We proceed. Thank you very much, Enrica. We have just two more questions in the GE form. And to one, we have given already repeatedly the answer. Rita Comet asked about changing logos and project partner description. I think this is super clear. Is it clear, yeah. Rita? Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. It's clear. Actually, I have another question. It's actually the same problem as Novamare project. So I don't know, maybe I can send you an email with our Google Track ID, another one, or I don't know.
Please pay attention to the format. The format is UA-number-. I show you, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I show you the format
which
GRID has to have. UA minus set of number minus one number, okay? This is the correct.
Okay.
In Novamare, as I write to... I don't remember to Danny, for perhaps I don't remember the name of the person that in Novamare not have this format, the GAID. Okay, it's very important. Give me this format of ID.
Mm-hmm. Yes, now have you heard?
Okay.
Is it okay?
Perhaps if Yasna.
Yes, yes, nice for,
yes, I'm here.
Gli ho scritto direttamente.
Okay. Erika wrote you directly, she said.
Yeah.
Also to Jasna, okay. Because the question of Rita was an additional one on the tracking. So.
Mm.
Okay.
Yes.
That said, we Thank have you. The last question from Natasha Ugrin from RERA Split. And that question was related to the alert issue that we have checked together with Enrica the other day. So basically, at the moment, right now, as the website is, we don't other functionalities other than these that you can see, okay? But we've seen, so we can clarify, here we are for that. If you mean, Natasha, a space for collecting the subscribers, because we do have that, and Enrica can show you how to use
that
section. So Natasha, please, if you are here with us,
okay,
don't be afraid to intervene. Jenny, ciao Jenny, the
Jenny,
colleagues.
The DIA manager for web content. Okay, thank you.
Okay, you have to reach the list of people who subscribe your email, correct? This is the your need, correct? You have to reach the list to to prepare a web alert by newsletter or by email in an external platform from our website, because in the website there is no feature of web alert at the moment. You can you can get the list of people who subscribe your email, and you can send externally an email to give evidence of the news on the site. This is corretto? Questa è l'esigenza?
Is this the correct interpretation of the need, Natasha, of yours?
Of the question? No.
Understand well, because we already have a section for subscribers on program newsletter. So in this you actually want to say that we can do the same thing with alerts. So in that way we have to prepare concrete material and send newsletter. It's mm-hmm. If I understand correctly what you're suggesting.
Yes. There is no feature of web alert.
If I'm not wrong, web alerts functions by themselves. We don't have to manage, but put the dates and connection with events, actually with the change on the web page, and then web alerts push the messages to.
For the events, for the stuff like this. No, Natasha, because we don't have it, not even for the program.
Okay, yeah, I understood you that you already explained that to me. Okay, but we can reserve that in some other way, but we can discuss with you, Thea, maybe without boring everyone here.
Yes, so. Yes, we can meet in a separate session also with Enrica and check it out.
That it's not possible for the website, so we can do it in another way. We already agree with our lead partner, and we have the proposal how to deal with that.
Okay.
Let me only say that in the manual you have the procedure to get the list of your subscriptor. Okay, so you will. You go in the right. Okay, the menu. Content, forms. You okay. Get stay updated. It is your form of subscription, and you can export. Okay, warning for CSV file, Excel or XML, yes. Uh-huh. And you get okay, and you get the download.
Yes, the second use for the newsletter.
Okay. Now I delete from my desktop now this information because there are email of external people. So yeah. Now okay. I delete this. Don't be afraid.
Okay, thank you, great. This is a great information. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Enrica. And with those we have finished with the questions we got through the G form, for which I thank you very much. It's always useful to have anticipation, because you never know how the things are going and if we have time, if we don't. However, I will take over. There are I think six questions from persons done via chat that my dear colleague Lovro Jurisic, super expert from Zadar, has helped me to collect them. Thanks a lot for the support again. So Anna from Anatesia asked us, could the deliverables be uploaded to the website with a later date after the project ending? Of course, you know, Anna, that of course it would be better if you did this activity during the project implementation, every time that these are finally edited and so, it would be better. But if you still have deliverables to upload,
Rika,
microphone.
Scusate.
If you still have to deliver, upload, and check out all of your website, you have time after your project. And I know that AdriaAdapt is finishing at 30th of June. You have 3 months still, you know. We are working also on that after the project and of course until we close the activity, because all the final requests for payment will be subject to the check also of these communication requirements and the final edited documents availability on the website and the correctness of editing of the documents on your project website. So don't worry, you have time. Zrinka again asked, do all the deliverables and outputs have to be published, or do we have a discretion on deciding ourselves and declaring a document as only eternal? I think that I have explained this already. Every final deliverable should be published. Every final deliverable as indicated in your application form, unless are excluded these from the work package one, that is the work package on management, and some others for which I've given you the example before, the confidential documents, the communication strategy, or some deliverables that are functional to reaching the publishing of the final document, final deliverable. So I think that this is quite clear. If still any doubt, let me know. So it's not your discretion, but there are some exceptions that we have explained. Okay. Methodology documents for example refers to the methodology documents and similar. Yes, depends. If the methodology is meant to be as a final deliverable itself, because it can be useful for your stakeholders on the territories, and you are preparing this as a final deliverable to put it on the disposal of someone else, it should be published. If it's functional to some production of other deliverable, not. But these are some cases and can be evaluated in ongoing. Okay, Vladimir, I think that I have also explained and given the answer to the question of Vladimir. If in the presentation it was written that they have to be an editable version, can they be in PDF? Yes, they should be generally in PDF. If you have other format, if these are brochures, for example, or I don't know, some infographics, these can be in JPEG or JPN, I don't know. I haven't seen that before, and PDF is better due to form. Yes, PDF it's fine. PDF it's fine, and the final document is better and it's PDF, of course. Do we need to upload only technical deliverables or communication management as well? Some of the deliverables are mailing lists and similar, so we think it would be wrong to publish them. Of course, this was explained and answered. Technical deliverables of the technical work packages and of the communication work package. Management, not. Deliverables that are mailing lists and similar, no, of course. Absolutely not. And if these refer to the audience from your events, I have explained how. in the follow-up report that explains shortly about the achievements and main speeches, main discussions that have taken place during the event. You have to mention also the total number of external audience, external to your project partnership, I mean. How was it composed? And then, of course, you can count this by the means of your registration form. You see, the 30 people from public authorities, regional public authorities, this two from local public authorities, et cetera, three from research institutions, and so on and so forth. So I think that this is clear. Some of our partners, Vladimir says, are in the publishing phase of some articles and books, and they will be published in the next few months. They already contacted JS about it. Is it fine if we don't publish them on time? It's important that you publish all the final deliverables before you ask for the final request for the reimbursement. It's okay. Because if the lead partner makes a request for in final reimbursement and you don't still have final deliverables, you probably won't get the final payment. Okay. Please do stop me if you need some additional one. Anna Sinkovic, do we have to choose a specific display page also when publish the events? I think that I have explained this too with Enrica. Yes, for the events and for the news, always choose a specific display page. That is the page of the priority access to which your project is belonging to, okay? And news or event. Nicoletta, is the portal manual you mentioned before the same as one uploaded in the program website? Yes, it is. I noted that the version uploaded is the 1.5 of 11th of November 2019. You can find it in the link I put in the chat. It's on the documents and tools. It's a project implementation documents communication section. And you can find it over there. Also, I will send you this presentation if you deem that it can be useful. And there is a direct link to each of these documents, the fact sheets and the guidelines to the website of the program. Okay, three more questions. And then Anna also asked that she wanted to upload some documents, but they were too heavy. I think that we have explained this already during answered. Luca said in his question that sometimes news or events or even library shown are not in the correct order temporarily, sorted by progressive date or by number. How can we reorder them? Yes, I've seen that there is a problem, and this is, I think, functional problem that we need to see with the systemist, with informatics and experts IT. With Enrica, because even myself, I've noticed that the dates are mixed, that are not ordered by date. So we need to set up this. It will be my point. I don't know, Enrica, if there is any tip or something that we are not doing right.
Not in this at this moment, I have to check.
Okay, I will write it down just to see how can we solve it, because also myself, I have had that problem and I have noticed it. And if we manage to solve it, then I think that we will, it will reorder automatically. And last question is from Nicoletta. She said also a media list could be considered not to be published if included in the communication plan report. Yes, it would be better. Not to. Just for because it contains a sensitive data, and perhaps in the process of checking and control of your websites before the final request for reimbursement. If we need it, if I need it, I will ask you that directly, but it's better that not to publish this sensible information.
But sorry, Thea, but at this point, it's better to erase only this part of the old document, or erase the whole document. So because I have already published, uploaded in the website the communication plan of the our project, mm-hmm. and within this document there is a paragraph mm-hmm. Where I listed the media we are going to.
Yeah. Understand. Because in your communication plan or strategy, because it's the same thing, somebody yes. also asked me. I would recommend not to publish this document at all, because as I said before, from my previous experience on projects, this communication plan or communication strategy, mm-hmm. as you wanted to call it, frequently contained also the analysis of stakeholders and their names. So it can be quite, how can I say, delicate document. Mm-hmm. So I would not, I would recommend to, of course, provided and uploaded in CU when you are reporting activities and expenditures related, but maybe not on the website.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, I'm here. The questions from chat, I think these are finished. And if you have any additional, please let me know. I have just checked one that Lovro referred about Flavio. Flavio said that the detail button doesn't work properly. Detail button where, Flavio?
Hello, I had uploaded an image. I don't know if you can find it. Senza nome. I can do it again.
Sì, I'm asked Flavio.
Ah, okay.
Sorry, I didn't see.
No, but I say it to all of you. We know there is a bug on the display page of the Docs and Tools. Randomic that gives randomic effect, and we are studying a solution now. Okay, so una anomalia nota, ecco.
Okay,
thank you.
Okay, questa for... second note, come aveva mm-hmm. detto, scusa.
È la detail dei Docs and Tools.
Sì. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. So are there any further questions? Now we have we've done all the questions, so don't hesitate. Please, Daniela.
Hi. I have a question about the publication in scientific journals. On my particular project, we already have 5 publications in scientific journals which mention Cascade, which I put in the last communication report. Now, would this be interesting information for our website, like news?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah. But I don't know how to put it, because there's of course also a right of the publisher. So I should just put the name of the publication and 2-3 lines or something like that and just screenshot it, I don't know. But it could be as a news.
Interesting to have as a news, of course, what the communication manager of the project should be able to do is to translate the scientific content in more communicative content by the means of an article or another kind of publication that can be also a flyer accompanied by the infographic that can explain the content of scientific publication, because people will not, I don't understand it, but also nobody understands it. So we have had a very good examples of the projects that have been working. I was really amazed, for example, on AdSwim, because one of their communication aims was really that one, to translate some of the scientific issues to the more user-friendly language and to, in order to come closer to the kids or to the other kinds of users to make them understand. So this is a little bit content management what the communication manager should do, and then of course the web content manager upload and take care of online, or if it's one person itself.
Okay, thank you. And the minutes, for instance, we had the, I don't know, steering committee yesterday, and there are the minutes now, which are written by leading partner. This should be an information for the web or not?
No, because this is work package one content. And it's not relevant for the website. So no work package one content, minutes of your steering committees, no attendance sheets, no. You can, if you need the website for communicating among your project partners, for example, the partner that is organizing it in the case of online or the offline, if we come back to the offline, for example, you can use your website to announce it like an event and not sending by email the agenda. So you say, dear partners, the next steering committee is taking place in Šibenik. On the website, there is a news. You can find the registration link and the agenda. Please register by this date and bye-bye. And you can download the draft agenda. You can use it for this purpose, but not for the library, for the, I don't know, steering committee minutes or procedures for internal management and documents like this. Just the communication and technical. Oh, mamma mia. Okay. Okay, any other question? And otherwise we can arrive to the end of this seminar, hoping that it was useful for you. Okay. Don't be afraid. If any other question, we can take one question or two, and otherwise we can close. We will have some registration. Some registration in two parts. I will try to put it together, because we have had that falling down on of Zoom. Managed to repair ongoing. It's important that we manage to arrive to the end and to clarify some issues. I thank very, very much to Erika for the support on this seminar. And for also preparing together, and we stay at your disposal, and I say goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Also, please, I would like to again thank Lovro, my dear colleague from Zadar, for helping me out with the chat. Thanks a lot for your availability, Lovro.
You're welcome, everybody.
Thanks a lot.
Good luck with your projects.
Thank you.
Okay.
I would like to thank you, Thea. You are very kind of you. It was very kind of you, this seminar.
Thank you, Luca. I hope it was useful, and for you. And don't forget, please, all of you, for you that still haven't done it, to check the Excel file that I have shared this morning, and to update if any change in the web content administrator. as I said to Daniela, you can, if you have human resources, you can manage it in 2, 3 people, 1 people, 5 people, whatever you want. But I need to have one appointed person for the communication among us, for the mailing list. And of course, as a reference point, it's a reference point for me as a program and also for your lead partner, okay? Because yeah, the appointed...
I will leave it like it is, because the one is an external person who will help, but then I will leave it like it is, my name.
Yes,
is...
yes, yes, it's fine, it's
yes,
fine.
It's more wiser.
Yes. Yes, it's fine, it's fine. Because, you know, the web content manager is always responsible to the lead partner, where the lead partner is responsible to the managing authority. So when it comes to something, to the end of so on and so forth, we have to have... appointed persons. This is why we created the project management unit at the beginning, so to have clear distinction of the persons, the roles, and to be able in any moment to refer to the person that is in charge for some activity. We haven't had any problems by now, but we need it also for in the case of any problem arises, or just for the communication purposes, and to be sure that our communications are reaching you. If nothing else, again, many, many thanks. And see you soon.
Okay, see you soon, Thea.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Grazie.
Grazie
a tutti.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll close now. Bye-bye.